five quarterbacks. I'm going to start this week in week 9. The first guy's Ben Roethlisberger of the Pittsburgh Steelers. Roethlisberger coming off of 2 tough matchups. He played decent, but not great enough for a top-tier fantasy quarterback. But this week, he's got the matchups of all in the Dallas Cowboys. Even though we saw Dallas come off a good defensive game versus Carson Wentz, holding him to 12 fantasy points, this is a different story with Big Ben in a high-powered offense with all those weapons in James Conner, Claypool, Juju, Johnson, and Ebron. So Big Ben, he's going to go out there. I think he's going to throw a party on the Dallas Cowboy weak secondary and defense. And I could see Ben having his biggest fantasy game of the year for him. He could have 30 to 35 points easily in this one. So go out there and start Ben this week. He's going to be a top 8 option, or even top 5 he can finish the week at quarterback. The second guy's Matthew Stafford of the Detroit Lions. Yes, I know Kenny Galladay's out, but the matchup is a very plus matchup for Matthew Stafford and the Detroit Lions. They're versus the Minnesota Vikings, who give up the 3rd most fantasy points to quarterbacks coming in. And Matthew Stafford, you know he's a gunslinger. He's not scared of putting that ball up deep down the sidelines or going into the end zone with double coverage and all. I know Galladay's out, but he's still got some guys there. And Swift, Marvin Jones, Marvin Hall's his deep ball guy. So, and TJ Hawkinson's out. Stafford, he had 30 fantasy points last week. This week, I could see a similar game because I think this game is going to be a shootout. The next quarterback's Kirk Cousins of Minnesota Vikings. We're staying in it with this game. Cousins last week, he didn't have to do much because of Dalvin Cook's eruption with 4 touchdowns. But Kirk Cousins, he's got a good matchup. Detroit gives up a lot of points. We just saw Phillip Rivers even go for 30 fantasy points on their defense. So Kirk Cousins, he's got Jefferson and Thielen. He's got Cook out of the backfield who could take a screen to the house like we saw in this week's game. So Kirk Cousins, he's a free agent in a lot of leagues. So you could go out there, pick him up, and fill him in for a bye week guy. Or if you're in a 2-quarterback league, just go out there and put him in. So he'll be the 3rd guy I'm starting. The next quarterback I'm going to start is Justin Herbert of the Los Angeles Chargers. A lot of questions I see. Should I start Herbert or this quarterback? I'm going with Herbert. He's a top 6-7 option each and every week is Herbert. And this week he's got a pretty good matchup versus the Las Vegas Raiders is Herbert. It's going to be a shootout. Every Charger game seems like it comes down to the last possession. And Herbert, I said this in other videos, it seems like each and every week he's putting up 3 touchdowns at 300 yards. And once again, I could see Herbert go for that. So no more questions. You auto start Herbert unless you got a Mahomes or Russell Wilson to start over him. Guys of that caliber. The next guy's Cam Newton, a guy who I haven't liked in a few weeks in fantasy purposes. But he's got the matchups of all matchups as well, like Ben Roethlisberger. Newton's versing the worst team in pro football in the New York Jets. They got nobody on defense. Quarterbacks, it seems like every week, have a monster game. Newton, he's going to run all over him. I could see Cam have his best fantasy game of the season. I could see him anywhere from 30 to 40 fantasy points. I know his receivers are banged up in Harry and Edelman, but it don't matter to me. This Jet defense can't cover no one. So Cam Newton, he's an easy start at the quarterback position.